It's unlikely. Surely, I wouldn't say it's impossible.
The threat of removal from office. House Speaker Nancy Pelosi announcing on Tuesday a formal impeachment inquiry of President Trump.
People may think of impeachment as some sort of constitutional crisis, but it's really the Congress acting under the Constitution to try to rein in a president that the Congress charges has abused his authority somehow.
The Constitution defines those abuses as treason, bribery, and high crimes and misdemeanors. It's what Associate Professor of Political Science David Holian describes as a violation of the public trust.
Part of the Constitution is to faithfully execute the laws of the country. Faithfully execute all the laws, not just the laws you like and ignore the laws you don't like.
Right now, the president faces allegations of using leverage to try to convince Ukraine to investigate his political opponent, former Vice President Joe Biden.
You had Democrats across the political spectrum, you know, saying basically, now's the time. We can't ignore this. We swore an oath to protect the Constitution, to defend it, and this is something that, you know, we simply can't ignore.
Now that an inquiry has been established, the House will continue to gather testimony and information. They will define one or more articles of impeachment, take a vote, and if the House votes to impeach, it then moves to the Senate for a trial.
Progressive Democrats have said is that you can't just assume that Republicans won't desert the president. The only way that's going to happen is if you lay out a case. And here's their opportunity to lay out a case. Is it likely? No, it's highly unlikely, but I wouldn't say it's impossible.
In order to remove the president from office, two-thirds of the Senate must vote to convict.